This is the big, that we call in your eye, the biggest story on the face of the earth. What is this? This is the, they are salmon, stillhead salmon, stillhead salmon. The 10-year mean? The 10-year mean is annihilated because they started to collapse in, you got it, the great coincidence freaking thing. A decade, great coincidence decade. 2012 on cue. The great nightmare. The greatest, biggest story on the face of the earth. Where's the annual totals? Okay. The Bonneville Dam on the Columbia River, 400 tributaries. This is... $416,000. So the year before was $680,000. So 2009 was $680,000. We'll use this. We'll go with $416,000. Still, now remember, they'll go to sea 1 to 2 years. They started to collapse in 2011 immediately because their life cycle is so short. Let's get over here to the Chinook. Look at these increasing numbers. Well, what Blanche is full of shit till 2015. They go to sea for 5. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, let's go back. Now remember these numbers. Don't forget, kiddies. Don't forget these numbers. Okay? We go from 416,000, we're down to 77,000. You don't think this is concerning? Now stay with me because this is with, they gill netted over. So this is important. Right here. That number is truly 738,000. Why? Because they gill netted over 360. So I verified this. They gill netted and caught over three in front of the dam. This is the dam, Bonneville now, before they get to the dam. So that this number was, Tim Martin told me today it was 685,000. And I talked to ODFW, it was 728,000. So they go from 728,000. No gill netting to 77. So that's down 90%. Okay? Let's stay with me. Remember those numbers. Again, this is no gill netting. All the dynasty, dynasty, dynasty. Stay with me. Okay? Let's get to the stillhead number. Come on.
Literally
14,000. There's no gill netting and there is no fishing. Has nothing to do with the dam. This is in front of the dam. They're dying at sea on record escapement. Record escapement has zero to do with gill netting. Okay, let's go back. Okay, so 14,000. We're just using the Bonneville because it's the biggest. Tim was on the road yesterday with the test netters. You saw it. They're coming back with zero in the test nets. Pull as many years as we can. You can work this over all you want, your own. You can run regression. So you just saw 14,000 for the year. Again, this number right here, well, actually, this number is over 800,000. 2011 is over 700,000. 700 because of gill netting and fishing. 700,000 to 77,000. That's where's the Endangered Species Act? The Endangered Species Act kicked in right here. So we're talking three administrations. No Greenpeace, no Sierra Club, no Friends of the Earth. Where is somebody suing these derelicts? They're in violation. Feds won't enforce their own law. Holy fuck. Two. Now stay with me. You just saw that number. I mean, how many times can I hammer it? $720,000 to $14,000. Well, God, the season isn't over. This is what's got me freaking, even Kevin Blanche, when he's startled and shocked on this. Scientists are mystified, they're baffled, they're stumped, they're perplexed, they're bewildered. They go to see 1 to 2 years. You can see this is the heart of the run, and this is the 10-year mean. Because the 10-year mean is so low, because you just saw why it's so low, kids. You know, this is for the upper division students. You can run regression. So where are we at? We're right at the top. It's prime time, baby. This is the greatest eagle. Dynasty, that's all. That's all. Just dynasty. Kevin Blanche, March 2011. Steelhead will collapse first. This tide pools will collapse right then. The Chinook salmon will collapse on cue in 2015. Bonneville is the biggest by far. 2.5 miles wide. 400 tributaries. Where do these salmon live? Monterey Bay. What? Yep. They live in the ocean. They don't live in rivers. They live in the ocean. Okay, let's go to Chinook. Again, that number is 1 point some odd million. I've verified this. Well, how come they didn't collapse? Because they go to sea for 5 years. Hello. Everybody's arguing. Look at these record returns. Record returns. 1,300,000. I verified this. They pulled out that many. It was well over 2.7 million. That's how many they caught in gillnet. Massive. They're going crazy. I set them. They had their number set here at 2.3 million. After the nets, I set mine at 680. I set mine at 480. They had theirs at 2.1 million. I set mine at 336. They had theirs set at 2 million. This is when they pulled the gill nets. So you can cut that in half. You think it's a catastrophe? You think it's a catastrophe? Smoking gun of Fukushima. By the way, not dams. Not dams, they're dying at sea. Unarguable. Unarguable. One last time. That's for the year. 14,000. And the sonar's in front of the dam. This is coming home. And we know how many escape and get out. It's not the dams. Don't tell me it's been going on for decades. Don't tell me it's going on for decades. Don't tell me. I'll go back to the annual totals again. Hammer this home to the goats. Fucking fools. Fukushima denies the greatest. It's the greatest crime in human history, is the cover up of Fukushima. To 14,000? To 14, and like I said, that's with gill netting and fishing, you can double that number. You can double that number. You can double that number. I've verified this over and over. They get 50% allotment, and they take all 50. Gill nets don't lie. So that number is what? 2.7 million. 2.7 million. Fuck, we're way under that now. To 2.7 million to 200,000? Steelhead? 800,000. Tim Martin has verified this. He says the real number right here was 680,000. Okay, I'll go with the 680,000. ODFW says it was 724,000, 25,000. Two. Go to see 1 to 2 years. Wake the fuck up. Well, let's do a Chinook. Let's. And by the way, still had all trout or salmon. All trout or salmon. They're salmonoids. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? To 14,000. From 680,000. None to see. None to see, kids. None to see, kids. Just the Pacific Ocean dying. Kevin Latch, the greatest PhD in human history, the great Pacific genocide, as I named it in the early days, not to mention I did all this work while I was full of cancer, given 2 months to live on 11-11-11. What's her name told me yesterday in Monterey? Kevin, you know you're synonymous and you are branded with the Fukushima disaster for time and eternity. And I says, just the greatest event in human history, the greatest crime in human history, the cover-up. She says, yep, the greatest event in human history, the greatest crime in human history, the greatest event, the denial, the cover-up, the event. She says, you're branded. Go think about that one. Think about that one. Whoa. Whoa. Well, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I fear no evil. Fucking heartbreaking. Heartbreaking. Unbelievable. What a fucking nightmare. No one seems to give a fuck. They want to still raise some Greenpeace, Sierra Club, friends that we all live in. They should be fucking rounded up and tried. Put him. All of Greenpeace, Sierra Club, everybody, they should be rounded up and tried and put in fucking prison cells. At least, well, I personally think it should be worse than that. Fucking bring back the double guillotine. Fucking scientists are mystified, they're baffled, they're puzzled, they're stumped, they're perplexed, they're bewildered. It's not science. In fact, that's opposite of science. These fucking PhDs, they fucking hand out like toilet. They're not PhDs, they're derelicts. They should be. Every marine biologist department, every fucking academia professor, biologist, marine biologist should be rounded up and put in fucking jail. It's the greatest ecological catastrophe in human history. What Kevin Blanche done, that's fucking science. First you hypothesis, these are fucking full-blown out meltdowns. They're burrowing into the Pacific Ocean. They come here, they live here. They live here. You get my fucking drift, California current. Fucking fools. Stand tuned.